Hare Krishna. Thank you. I am also very much happy to be back. Thank you. We are going to read from Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, Madhya Leela, chapter 20, and we'll start from the text number 118. Om Ajnanati Mirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurin Militam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtham Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Svapadantikam Vandeham Sri Guru Sri Yuta Padakamalam Sri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Sri Rupam Sagajatam Sahagana Raghunatham Vitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Sri Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Sri Vishakhan Vitamscha He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dinavandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Shirada Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Shirade Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Bancha Kalpataru Vyascha Kripa Sindhu Vyayevacha Patitanam Pavanivyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namo Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shiva Sadhihura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Reading from Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Leela Chapter 20 Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu instructs Sanatan Goswami in the science of the Absolute Truth. Starting from the text number 118. Kobu sarge uthayo, kobu naroke dubayo, dandyo jani raja jano, nodite chubayo. In the material condition, the living entity is sometimes raised to higher planetary system. And material prosperity. And sometimes drowned in a hellish situation. His state is exactly like that of a criminal whom a king punishes by submerging him in water and then raising him again from the water. Purport. In the Brihadaranyaka Upanishad 4.3.16, it is stated, Asango hi ayam purushah. The living entity is always free from the contamination of the material world. One who is not materially infected and who does not forget Krishna as his master is called Nitya Mukta. In other words, one who is eternally liberated from material contamination is called Nitya Mukta. From time immemorial, the Nitya Mukta living entity has always been a devotee of Krishna and his only attempt has been to serve Krishna. Thus he never forgets his eternal servitorship to Krishna. Any living entity who forgets his eternal relationship with Krishna is under the sway of the material condition. Bereft of the Lord's transcendental loving service, he is subjected to the reactions of fruitive activity. When he is elevated to the higher planetary systems due to worldly pious activities, he considers himself well situated. But when he is subjected to punishment, he thinks himself improperly situated. Thus, material nature awards and punishes the living entity. When the living entity is materially opulent, material nature is rewarding him. When he is materially embarrassed, material nature is punishing him. So, in this wonderful section, where Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is enlightening Srila Sanatan Goswami about the goal of life. First, he started giving the enlightenment about the constitutional position of the living entity. And then he is describing about the conditioned state of the conditioned souls, bound up souls within the material world. So in the previous verse he said, forgetting Krishna, the living entity has been attracted by the external feature from time immemorial. Therefore, the illusory energy, Maya, gives him all kinds of misery in his material existence. So this is a punishable crime, actually, if we remain absorbed in the material energy. Why it is punishable crime? Because we are not situated properly in our own position. For enlightening about our real position, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared, and to enlighten our real dharma, he appeared, and he gave us full understanding. The whole process is to awaken the soul to the proper position. As soon as the soul is properly situated in its position, eternal position, then the soul can perform, function properly in relationship with Sri Krishna. That is the Nitya Dharma. And that soul is known as Nitya Mukta. But right now we are all Baddhajeev, conditioned souls are bound up souls. We are bound by the three modes of material nature within the material energy. So, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is enlightening us about that. In the material condition we are going through this situation, sometimes good, sometimes bad. We are living in the world of duality. Here, nothing is permanent, there's no situation is permanent unless the soul is situated again to its proper position. He would not be released from the bondage. And that is our goal, to come to the platform of liberation. That is our liberated stage. When we place ourselves into that proper position. But placing the soul by awakening the soul on the proper platform, we can perform our dharma. Then there will be no miseries at all. Otherwise, there's always miseries, either in the body or mind. Everyone has some suffering, either physically or mentally. Suffering is there. Either pain in the body or pain in the mind, or both. No one is exceptional. And the punishment is compared like this, you know. Like in olden time, a criminal would undergo this kind of punishment. The Raj Karmachari or the king's men would submerge him, the criminal, under water. And the criminal could not breathe. So to give little relief, they would again raise him above the water. above, means from the water. And when the criminal would breathe, he would think, I'm enjoying the life. And after a little time, again they would submerge him. So this pose is not very good condition. Means constant suffering is there in this material world. Constant, constant, constant. Material energy is punishing us or giving us trouble constantly. When there's no trouble for a brief period, then we think, I'm so happy. I'm in very good condition. And next moment, again, situation changes. And purposely these things are going on. Why? To bring us to the senses, to recognize our own swarupa, situated in our, to be situated in the swarupa. In the swarupa, there's only ananda, bliss. There's no misery at all. So we must be captivated by this information that we must come to that existence where there's no miseries. In the material condition, these tribulations are going on. But in the liberated stage, liberated platform, the tribulation is not there. Although physical problems will be there, but the person will be able to endure, can transcend the situation. So this is a very important point here. What Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is speaking, he is Krishna himself, of course, and Srila Prabhupada is explaining. We must understand this point. That's why Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is enlightening Srila Sanatana Goswami. Unless we are awakened to the real position, we are not going to get relief anywhere within the material existence. So now, next verse, 119, beautiful verse from Srimad Bhagavatam. Vayam dvitya vinivesatah syat ishada petasya viparyayo smitihi tanmayayato buddha abhajitam bhaktaikayesham guru devatatma. Vayam, fear. Vitya avinivesataha, from the misconception of being product of material energy. Syat arises, ishat, from the Supreme Personality of Godhead Krishna. Apetasya, of one who has withdrawn the conditioned soul. Of one who has withdrawn the conditioned soul. Viparyayaha, reversal of the position. Asmitihi, no conception of his relationship with the Supreme Lord. Tat mayaya, because of the illusory energy of the Supreme Lord. Ataha, therefore, budhaha, one who is wise, abhajet, must worship tam, him. Bhaktya, by devotional service. Ekaya, undiverted to karma and jnana. Isham, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Guru, as the spiritual master, Devata, the worshipable Lord, Atma, the super soul. Translation, when the living entity is attracted by the material energy, which is separate from Krishna, he is overpowered by fear. Because he is separated from the Supreme Personality of Godhead by the material energy, his conception of life is reversed. In other words, instead of being the eternal servant of Krishna, he becomes Krishna's competitor. This is called viparyayo smriti. To nullify this mistake, one who is actually learned and advanced worships the Supreme Personality of Godhead as the spiritual master, worshipful deity, and source of life. He thus worships the Lord by the process of unalloyed devotional service. Purport, This is a quotation from Srimad Bhagavatam 11.2.37. It is an instruction given by Kabi Rishi, one of the nine saintly personalities called the nine Yogendras. When Vasudev Krishna's father asked Devarshi Narada in Dwarka about devotional service, it was mentioned that previously King Nimi, who was the king of Videha, was instructed by the nine Yogendras. When Sri Narada Muni discoursed on Bhagavata Dharma, devotional service, he indicated how a conditioned soul can be liberated by engaging in the loving transcendental service of the Lord. The Lord is the super soul, spiritual master and worshipable deity of all conditioned souls. Not only is Krishna the supreme worshipful deity for all living entities, but he is also the Guru or Chaitya Guru, the super soul, who always gives the living entity good counsel. Unfortunately, the living entity neglects the Supreme Person's instructions. He thus identifies with the material energy and is consequently overpowered by a kind of fear resulting from accepting himself as the material body and considering paraphernalia related to the material body to be his property. All types of fruitive results actually come from the spirit soul. All types of fruitive results actually come from the spirit soul, but because he has forgotten his real duty, he is embarrassed by many material consequences such as fear and attachment. The only remedy is to revert to the service of the Lord and thus be saved from material nature's unwanted harassment. So Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami or Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is giving us the reference of his statement. We must give the evidence from the bona fide transcendental scriptures. So Srimad Bhagavatam is our standard of evidence. So this verse says everything very nicely, how we are being harassed or being punished by the material nature. Why? Because we are committing a punishable crime. That's the point we have to understand. Like we read Bhagavad Gita. By reading Bhagavad Gita, when you understand the subject matter, the truth, we have to live by the truth. We have to live by the instruction of Sri Krishna as he is giving the help or instructions or guidance. We must be very eager to live according to the principle of Bhagavad Gita. From the very second chapter, Sri Krishna is enlightening, you are the spirit soul. So we have to come to that position. We have to place ourselves in that position. And we must keep ourselves in that position, which is transcendental position, beyond the three modes of material nature. By keeping ourselves in the transcendental position, we must act as a devotional service to Lord. That is known as karma yoga. Only act for the pleasure of the Supreme Lord by understanding, realizing our eternal position. So we must be very eager. We must change our lives to live according to the instructions of Bhagavad Gita. Same point Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is now elaborating. Atma is not any impersonal entity. Atma is part and parcel of Supreme Person, Krishna. So Atma is the transcendental person, personality. As Sri Krishna is the transcendental personality. Atma is a form, as Krishna is a form. And we have personal relationship with Krishna. We have to live by this principle. If we are not living by this principle, then we put ourselves into that miserable conditions voluntarily. We are pushing ourselves. We are voluntarily putting ourselves into this situation. Nobody is responsible for our miserable conditions. We ourselves are responsible. After reading Bhagavad Gita, after understanding the principle of Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam and Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, if we are not changed yet, then who can save us? Again, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is taking time to enlighten us. And Srila Sanatan Goswami also was very much a determined person. He wanted to join Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu by any means. So he sacrificed all his wealth because he didn't consider this his wealth as more valuable than spiritual enlightenment. He was not at all attached to the material possessions, wealth, prosperity, opulence. So we must be also like that, ready to sacrifice everything for self-realization. Our life should be the life of self-realization. That intense desire must be there, by hook or crook, by any means, I have to achieve that perfection. We must achieve the direct association of the Supreme Lord. It doesn't matter, whatever it takes, I'm ready to do it. Sanatan Goswami did it that. He was imprisoned, we heard that. And whatever wealth he had, he gave everything to the, you know, the person who was taking care of him in the jail to get release from this sin condition. For what reason? To be with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. For what? To get this self-realization. Now he's asking these questions. So we have to take full advantage of these signs. This is our goal, aim. We should not settle for anything less than that. We should follow in the footsteps of Sri Sanatana Goswami. And while traveling toward Prayag, whatever coins his servant was carrying, he also gave away everything. So this is the point we have to learn. We should not have any attachment for anything other than self-realization. Before our death, we must get it. We must awaken our soul into that position. Again, come back to the original position. Be ready for the change. So here this verse says very beautiful points, and in the Srimad Bhagavatam the purport is really long and wonderfully explained. But in this short purport given by Srila Prabhupada, very important points we are going to learn. Actually, the Kavi Rishi says this verse, wonderful verse. So when the living entity is attracted by the material energy, then it happens. Otherwise not. Otherwise there is no misery. This is the point we have to understand. And from Mohini Murti pastimes, Lord Krishna's Mohini Murti past tense. Also, we learned the same point. His beautiful form, feminine form, which is known as Mohini Murti, attracted the asuras, demons. Demons were attracted to the beauty of Mohini Murti. Mohini Murti represents the material energy. The demons are attracted to the material energy, beauty of the material energy. Shri Krishna, Srila Prabhupada says, dazzling, dazzling, what is called, dazzling beauty of this material world. Illusory energy, illusory beauty or illusory attraction. Because the demons were attracted to the Mohini Murti, but Mohini, what she did? She did not give the nectar to the asuras. So if we are attracted to the material energy, we will be bereft of all nectar of Krishna consciousness. There will be nothing for us. This is an important point we have to understand. We think this material nature, material world is for our enjoyment. We are attracted to this material energy, by the material energy. But our acharyas are showing we should be attracted for Krishna's mercy, the enlightenment, the self-realization. Whatever he has given in Gita or Bhagavatam or Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, we have to die for it. There is no peace until we become self-realized person. How can we rest? How can we enjoy anything? So this translation says very beautifully, when the living entity is attracted by the material energy, which is separate from Krishna, because of our attraction for the material energy, separates us from Krishna's mercy, from Krishna's association. Because our attention is now diverted from Krishna. And for what reason we are attracted? To enjoy, to dominate, to lord it over the material energy. If we understand Tattvata, this material energy transcendentally one with Krishna, this material energy is the Krishna product or byproduct of Krishna, then we'll be very much respectful to the material energy. We must respect, honor the material energy as Krishna's energy, not to enjoy or dominate or lord it over, but to honor. Everything is nothing but Krishna's another form, varieties of Krishna's form, or varieties of Krishna's products. All are made of Krishna. Like sunshine is the product of sun. Similarly, this material energy is the product of Krishna. It is not false, but it has some specific function. It deludes us. He is overpowered by fear. This is the first symptom. We live in fear, fear of future. We cannot live in present moment. The common people, they are always worried about the future. They do everything for the future. They plan, their mind is always absorbed for the future worry, future plan. So they cannot live in the present moment. Future is unknown to us, so we are always fearful about the future. What will happen? What will happen? How can I survive? How can... Like that, overpowered by fear. See, eating, sleeping, mating and defending or fear is the one items of the four principles of material existence. Means, four stages of material existence. Four principles is Janma, Mrityu, Jara, Vyadhi. But these are the material functions, eating, sleeping, mating and defending. Unless we come to the spiritual platform, we always will be fearful. It is impossible to get over the fear, to transcend the fear, because he is separated from the Supreme Personality of Godhead by material energy. This point must be understood by us very deeply. His conception of life is reversed. Yes, I am the product of material energy. I have to take care of myself. I have to do this or that for my security, for my protection. Not seeing Krishna is present everywhere. Not seeing that I am inseparable part of Krishna and Krishna is protecting. Krishna is my master. Krishna is my protector. Accept Krishna as our master, protector. Then where's the fear? And Krishna is ready for that, to take care of us. It's not that he is not ready. He is also very eager, more eager than us. In other words, instead of being the eternal servant of Krishna, he becomes Krishna's competitor. What is the meaning of being Krishna's competitor? We become enjoyer. We place ourselves, we see ourselves as enjoyer controller. Which are not, which we are not. We are subordinate to Krishna's will. Our position is subordination to Krishna. We are always under Krishna. We are always under the control of Krishna. That position we are not ready to accept. We feel it's like as good as death sentence. If you let someone to control your life, that means you are dead already. It's material idea. But our most glorious position is being a part of parcel of Krishna. And when we place ourselves voluntarily under his protection, under his care, under his will, that is our most glorious position. And we experience boundless joy, happiness in that position. We feel so much secured, protected, and sheltered. There's no worry whatsoever for anything. For example, Sanatana Goswami did not feel any worry when he was giving away all the wealth for anything. His only goal was how to go to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That is our goal also. Accept Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as all in all and always place him in the deep core in the heart. Always keep Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu within the heart. That is actually our goal. We become Krishna's competitor. We think I can control my situation and I can enjoy. Neither I can control, neither nor I can enjoy. This is called Viparyayo Smriti, means reversal of life. The conception of life is reversed, means opposite truth. This is false platform, not truth. To nullify the mistake, what to do? One who is actually learned and advanced worships the Supreme Personality of Godhead as his spiritual master, worshipful deity and source of life. Wonderful. Isham Guru Devata Atma. He thus worships the Lord by the process of unalloyed devotional service. To perform unalloyed devotional service, we have to first put ourselves on our eternal position. Place ourselves, keep ourselves on the eternal position. On that platform, only we are able to render unalloyed devotional service. Our mind is totally focused, concentrated, only one thing, how to please the Lord. For his pleasure, we must exist, not for nothing else. So Srila Prabhupada says the same thing, that Krishna is our guru, Chaitya Guru. He gives instructions from within and from outside spiritual master and scriptures, transcendental scriptures and deity form. Srila Prabhupada says, Krishna in Vaikuntha and Krishna as a deity form in our temples are the same. This is Krishna's incarnation. Krishna has innumerable incarnations. So deities, wherever they are, he's expanding his form. That's it. So we are helping Krishna to expand, nothing else, Srila Prabhupada was saying. We are witnessing that Krishna's incarnations as deity form and expanding, Krishna's forms are being expanded more and more. There's not a single fraction difference. When you see deity forms of Krishna here and when someone is seeing Krishna in the spiritual world, no difference, because Krishna is absolute truth. Krishna kindly came to us, reached us as deity forms, because it is transcendental truth. This is not material truth. Here, even if I see the picture of Krishna, means it is as good as seeing Krishna in the spiritual world. No difference. Distance, time, space disappear actually when we are in the transcendental platform. For example, if I call my brother India right now, I will feel that he is just sitting by my side. It is the same. From thousands of miles away, if I'm speaking to him, or if I go to his next door and call him up, same thing. Distance doesn't matter. Time doesn't matter. If it is possible materially, I know you understand it is same. Calling from here and calling from just next door to him is the same. Or talking to him directly there in his home. Same. It's the same thing. If I offer my love and devotion over here to the deities, it is the same. Going to the spiritual world and offer my love and devotion to Supreme Lord. No difference. We have to be enlightened by the transcendental science, transcendental subject matter. That totally different from the material science. This is so wonderful. Holy name is Krishna. There's no difference. Deities, no difference. Paramatma, Chaitanya Guru, no difference. And our spiritual masters, that is also no difference. Sometimes we ask this question, how can I understand this transcendental subject matter, or how can I leave off the intellectual platform, come to the transcendental platform? Answer is, Guru Krishna Prasadipaya Bhakti Lata Beach. We must be favored by or empowered by the mercy of Guru and Krishna simultaneously. And Srimad Bhagavatam also says, Hari Guru Charana Seva Upasana Astram. Hari Guru Charana Seva, simultaneously. And every day we sing in the Gurvashtakam, right? Yasya Prasadat Bhagavat Prasadam. Yasya prasadat na gati guto. Dhanyam nitruvam, what is that? Means when I sing, nice. Means I meditate the lotus feet of my spiritual master. By his mercy, Lord is merciful. Lord Krishna becomes happy. If my spiritual master is pleased with me, then Lord Krishna is pleased with me. And if my spiritual master is displeased with me, then there's no way I can please the Supreme Lord. So relationship is very intimate. Without having favor or mercy, without pleasing the Supreme, the spiritual master, we cannot attain Krishna's mercy. What we are desiring for. we will not be able to live up the intellectual platform. Intellectually, I may understand many things, but still, I'm within the material energy, entangled. So this point is also very important. He is the same guru inside as Chaitanya Guru, outside as spiritual master. There's no difference, because spiritual master carries the same power, potency, and mercy, and knowledge. And spiritual master is also able to empower us to realize the transcendental subject matter. So Krishna must be dear like that. We should accept Krishna like that. Devata Atma, as my Atma is so dear to me. So Krishna is the most, Krishna is the dearest person, or most dearest person for me. So Guru Krishna, both mercy simultaneously important for us. We cannot jump over Guru and come to Krishna. Never. Without having spiritual master's mercy, I cannot approach even Shri Radha Krishna. This is the truth we have to learn. And be ready to do anything and everything to reach our destination. To achieve the science of self-realization. And Sanatana Goswami showed that practically. By going through so much trouble, finally he reached Prayag and he asked very relevant questions for our benefit. And now Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is enlightening Srila Sanatana Goswami for our benefit. So this is the point. And Srila Prabhupada said, but he is also our guru, also guru, the Chaitanya Guru, the super soul, who always gives the living entity good counsel. From within, Krishna speaks, but we are not attentive to it. But from outside, from Gita, Bhagavatam, we also hear the same personality. Unfortunately, the living entity neglects the Supreme Person's instructions. He thus identifies with the material energy and is consequently overpowered by a kind of fear resulting from accepting himself as the material body and considering paraphernalia related to the material body to be his property. Me and mine. I am material body and the family is mine, property is mine, everything is mine. Totally false understanding. From Gita, whatever instruction we are learning, we have to live by that instruction. That is the point. Then we'll be benefited. Otherwise, we'll be situated on the false platform and we'll be suffering endlessly. So this is the point. All types of fruitive results actually come from the spirit soul. But because he has forgotten his real duty, he is embarrassed by many material consequences such as fear and attachment. Fear for losing everything, fear of losing job, fear of losing money, reputation, name, fame, fear of losing body, status, everything. Constant fears are there because of the attachment. And Sanatana Goswami showed that. Because he was completely detached from any material opulence, name, fame, any material security, nothing was attractive for him. His only focus was to go to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That kind of strong determination we also must have. So the only remedy is to revert to the service of the Lord and thus be saved from the material nature's unwanted harassment. So wonderfully, our Acharya Srila Prabhupada is helping us. We also must live by that instructions. That's the point. Follow that instructions in our lives. Now 120, Sadhu Shastra Kripayo Jodi Krishnan Mukha Hayo সেই জীব নিস্তারে মায়া তাহারে ছাড়য়। ইফ দ্য কন্ডিশন সোল বিকমস কৃষ্ণ কনশিয়াস বাই দ্য মার্সি অফ সেন্টি পার্সনস হু ভলান্টারিলি প্রিচ স্ক্রিপচুরাল ইনজাংশনস অ্যান্ড হেল্প হিম টু বিকম কৃষ্ণ কনশিয়াস, দ্য কন্ডিশন সোল ইজ লিবারেটেড ফ্রম দ্য ক্লচেস অফ মায়া হু গিভস হিম আপ। পারপোর্ট, এ কন্ডিশন সোল ইজ ওয়ান who has forgotten Krishna as his eternal master, thinking that he is enjoying the material world. The conditioned soul suffers the threefold miseries of material existence, saintly persons, sadhus, Vaishnavas, devotees, and the Lord, devotees of the Lord preach Krishna consciousness on the basis of the Vedic literature. It is only by their mercy that the conditioned soul is awakened to Krishna consciousness. When awakened, he is no longer eager to enjoy the materialistic way of life. Instead, he devotes himself to the loving transcendental service of the Lord. When one engages in the Lord's devotional service, he becomes detached from material enjoyment. Bhakti hi pareshan ubhava viraktir anyatra chaisya trika eka kalaha. Bhagavatam 10.2.42. Beautiful verse. This is the test by which one can tell whether he is advancing in devotional service. One must be detached from material enjoyment. Such detachment means that Maya has actually given the conditioned soul liberation from illusory enjoyment. When one is advanced in Krishna consciousness, he does not consider himself as good as Krishna. Whenever he thinks that he is the enjoyer of material advantages, he is imprisoned in the bodily conception of life. However, when he is freed from the bodily conception, he can engage in devotional service, which is his actual position of freedom from the clutches of Maya. This is all explained in the following verse from the Bhagavad Gita 7.14. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking to Sanatana Goswami about the science of self-realization. Sadhu Shastra Kripaya Jodi Krishna Mukha Hai. We must receive the mercy of Sadhu Shastra. If the conditioned soul becomes Krishna conscious by the mercy of saintly persons and who voluntarily preach scriptural injunctions and help him to become Krishna conscious. What is the meaning of being Krishna conscious? Being in Krishna consciousness means when we engage ourselves in divine consciousness. That is known as Krishna consciousness. Yoga Yukta. Yoga means engaging our consciousness as a divine part and parcel of Krishna. We cannot lose the vision of reality. This is reality. Always remain engaged in divine consciousness about our own Surupa. Atma is consciousness. Atma is both conscious and consciousness. So we must remain engaged in the divine consciousness, Yoga Yukta. That is the meaning of remain engaged in the transcendental living service, loving service, transcendental loving service. Because we are living entities, we are consciousness entities. Consciousness is the real principle. If we engage ourselves in material consciousness, then we are materially situated. We are bound up by the three folds of material nature. Thus we suffer continuously. If our consciousness is engaged for the service of the Lord, then we are on the liberated platform. So when one is engaged in divine consciousness, in transcendental consciousness, when one is awakened to the real position of Atma, then he automatically is liberated. And that person is known as Krishna conscious person. That is the point. The conditioned soul is liberated from the clutches of Maya, who gives him up. This is very simple as well as very difficult. It is difficult for them who is not willing to be changed. Change must be done by the mercy of Guru, Shastra, Sadhu and Krishna. Sadhu means included spiritual master. Sadhu means saintly person. Saintly persons means spiritual master is also included within this term Sadhu. And Shastra. Sadhu or spiritual master always speak on the transcendental subject matter. Transcendental literature, Shastra. By their mercy, means by their preaching or knowledge, when we become Krishnan Mukha, when we become Krishna conscious or turn our face, Mukha means face, turn our face toward Krishna. Only fixed up in that position, turning our face toward Krishna, not turning away our face from Krishna. At that stage, we attain liberation. The soul is now fortified with the transcendental knowledge, backed by the knowledge. We heard, or we are constantly hearing from Sadhu, Guru, Shastra, about the real goal of life and about the means how to achieve the goal. Then we are able to turn our face toward Krishna, Krishnan Mukha. At this stage, the devotee can see always Krishna, eye to eye, transcendentally. How it happens, conditioned souls cannot understand. But we have to experience that. Because Krishna never disappears from them, and they also never disappear from Krishna. That is the point. In Gita, we know the complete Krishna consciousness stage is what? Yomam pashyati sarvatra, sarvam cha mai pashyati. Tasyaham na pranashyami sa cha mayena pranashyati. They can see Krishna constantly because they are now faced toward Krishna. Krishna unmukha. And Krishna also sees them constantly. So they can see eye to eye. They can see each other. Never miss Krishna. Never lose Krishna. This is the liberated platform. We must come to this platform. Then our journey back home, back to Godhead is possible. Otherwise, it takes a long, long time, many lives, many lifetimes it may take. So this is the point we have to understand. Sadhu and Shastra, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, without going to the mercy of spiritual master, without going to the mercy of sadhus, we cannot achieve this platform. Without going through the proper enlightenment from Shastra, you cannot achieve this platform. So the means how to achieve the stage of self-realization is also being explained by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is giving us the whole science. And it is not so difficult at all. It is not external, it is internal. So it is possible by everyone. There is no difficulty to accept ourselves as soul, because we are souls. That is the truth about the soul, means us. So that is the point. And Srila Prabhupada is helping us very nicely by giving us this purport. If we put ourselves in competition with Krishna, we will never be successful. Krishna is infinite. Krishna is unlimited and all-pervading. And I am just a tiny soul, a part of Krishna. How can I put myself in that competition if I want to be enjoyer, controller, creator? Then I'm doomed. I'm conditioned. Because of our wrong kind of consciousness, we are suffering. If we have proper consciousness, there's no suffering. This is the truth. This is known as science of self-realization. And this is the most important wealth in human life. We must be ready to sacrifice anything and everything to achieve this self-realization. Whatever Krishna said in Bhagavad Gita, same point Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is speaking, because he is the same Krishna, same science. So we must be ready to live by these instructions. Whatever Sri Krishna, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is speaking. As soon as we experience Krishna's presence, then immediately we become virakti. We become detached from any material enjoyment. How can we experience the presence of Krishna? By engaging ourselves in Lord's transcendental loving service, transcendental devotional service. We must voluntarily put ourselves into service. Deity forms of Krishna are none different from Krishna. Deity forms of Krishna in temple, none different. Same service, same presence of Krishna. Just we must engage ourselves in loving devotional service, and we experience that we are not attached to the material energy. We are not we are not attracted for material enjoyment. Nothing. And we experience Krishna, and we feel so much joy, satisfaction through this. So on the platform of liberation, it is available, but when we remain conditioned, it is not at all available for us. Therefore, we must be ready to follow Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's instructions. All right. Thank you so much. We covered up to 120. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hari Bol, Hare Krishna. Is there any question or comment here?
Hare Krishna, Mata. Thank you for a very enlightening class. And I really, the part that I really liked was when you were explaining that the deity forms are, we are actually seeing the incarnations of the Lord multiply before our eyes. That was really, really quite revealing. Thank you, Mataji.
Thank you. Phaneshwari, right? You are Phaneshwari?
Yes, Mataji, Phaneshwari.
Ah, Haribo.
Haribo. Yeah. So nice to hear
your voice. Yeah, Srila Prabhupada was saying. And we can experience that. Because it is on the absolute platform. That's why. Just a second. I have one phone call, please. Now, okay, Hare Krishna. I'm back. So, yes, yeah, the chanting, holy name, absolutely same. Krishna is here with me. We have to come to the transcendental platform. Everything is nicely experienced. Hare Krishna. One more time. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. We're here.
Yes, Mataji, we are listening to you.
Haripada, I'm sorry. I'm back. My son was calling from another country. That's why I, you know. Anyway. Oh, yes, I'm back. So this is the point. Whole thing. Come to the real position of the soul. Thank you, Vaneshwari. Is there anything else?
Hare Krishna, Mata, Savitri Mataji, Dandavat Pranam, all the Shilu
Prabhupada. Hare Krishna. Dandavat Pranam.
Mataji, how nicely you explained the Leelas, and you told that Guru Shastra Sadhu Krishna, Guru Krishna Krupa Paye Bhakti Lata Beach. Mataji, 100 pranam to your seva. How nicely explained. Every time, Mataji, like our mother is studying Bhagavatam class in our house. Thank you, Mataji, dandavat pranam.
Thank you, thank you. Yes. We are all learning from Shastra and from our
Mataji in front of us. Thank you very much for your association, Mataji. Thank we are housewives, we are not able to go in a class, a Bhakti Vriksha class, and every day we get association of Vaishnava. Jai Gopinath, yes. Jai Ho.
Yes, yes, very nice. Yes, we must take the full advantage of it. The
Hare Krishna Mataji, thank you so
Hare
much.
Krishna.
Thank you so much for your wonderful class, for coming back and giving us all your warmth and love. Thank you, Mataji.
Thank you.
Anyone else has any questions or comments? Okay, so we can end the class. Thank you.
Okay, all right. Okay. Bancha kalpatarubhyascha kripa sindhuvayeva cha patitanam pavanevyo vaishnavasyo namo namo. Shri Chaitanya Chaitamrita ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Gaur Premanande, Hari Hari Bol, Hare Krishna. All the Vaishnavas ki jai.
Mataji ki jai.
Gaur Bhaktavinda ki jai. Hari Bol.
Dandavat Pranam to your Seva Mataji. Hari Hari Bol.